Namaskaram everyone. Good morning students. Welcome to another interesting session of mathematics. I take this honor, I'm privileged to be a part of TSMS webinars and mathematics team. One strong pillar of mathematics team is today's speaker, Mrs. E. Purnima, PGT Mathematics from TSMS Valigunda. She is going to take you through another interesting topic. Maybe you must have read it in the flyer that it is matrices, but it is the first time that you're going to learn matrices, students. So by this time, you are familiar with paper 1A and 1B. Till yesterday, we have been doing straight lines from paper B. Now, we are going back to 1A. Purnima madam is well known to you. She has already taught you locus from 1B. Now, she is here to present matrices to you. The first session of matrices will include the basic understanding about a matrix, the order of a matrix, what are the different types of matrices. And madam has given you and is going to give you beautiful examples to understand it. Please be ready with a paper and pen and make a note of each and every point and also solve the questions that madam has is going to give you. Over to you, Purnima madam, and welcome.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Welcome, children. Welcome to our webinar class. Good morning, children. Good morning, ma'am. And good morning, Sridevi madam. Good morning, Manjari ma'am. And all other entire webinar team. Children, hope everyone is doing good. Today we are going to start very, very interesting chapter, children, which is matrices from paper 1A. Very, very interesting chapter, children, and very easy chapter also. And in examination point of view, if I say, the weightage is also more for this chapter. For this chapter, we have 22 marks of weightage, children. So here, let us start our matrices chapter, children. So be ready with your book and pen. So let us introduce the matrices chapter, children, today. So first of all, I hope everyone know about school buses, isn't it? Yes? Yes or not? So here in this picture, what you are going to see, what you are seeing, children, it is what? The children are boarding a school bus. Yes? What do you observe here, children? What do you observe here? It is
sitting in
picture of school bus, children boarding a school bus. Yes. So how they are boarding, children? By seeing the picture, what can you understand? How they are boarding?
They are walking in.
Yes, they are going in a line. They are boarding in a. They are boarding a bus in a proper order. They are boarding the bus in a proper line. Okay. So let us see one more picture, children. So what is this, children? After going to school, what is the first thing we do? We join a school assembly. Yes or not? We join the school assembly. So here you can see the image of a school assembly, children. So here, what do you observe, children? Here the principal is standing over here in the front row, front, and here all the children are standing one after one behind the other. Yes. So here, how they are standing, children? In our schools also, every day we are doing our assembly or not? Yes. So how we are standing, children? How we stand in the assembly? We stand one behind the other in a proper order. Yes or not? So school wise or section wise, we have sections. So section wise we stand. Yes or not? So that means what here? We are standing in a proper line. We are standing in a proper line and proper order. Yes. So we are not scattered here and there. Just we are standing in a proper line. Yes. So let us see one more image, children. Here, what is this? It is also a school children's picture, children. So what is here? What is there in this picture? It is a Republic Day or Independence Day celebration. It is what? Independence Day celebration. Here children are doing march past. Can you observe here the postures of the children here, children? So the children are doing here march past. They are doing. They are standing in a proper order. Here the first row, first in the first column, and here the first column, here another column. So the children are standing one behind the other in a proper order. Yes. So now let us see one more picture, children. So by this time you might be thinking that why ma'am is showing so many pictures. So it is totally connected to our chapter, children. So later you'll understand it. So let us see few more pics to understand it more clearly. Okay. So what is this here, children? Let us see one more pic. So what is this, children? It is an aeroplane. Yes. So how the seats are there? How the seats are arranged in the aeroplane? See, when you buy a ticket, it may be aeroplane or it may be train or anything, children. So if you book a ticket prior. Means before itself, before you board the plane or bus or train, anything, when you buy a ticket before itself, so the on the ticket volume, what you will find? The place, means the position of our place, means where we have to sit. Yes or not? So on that ticket, according to the position only, we go and sit in our place. So we cannot sit wherever we want. Yes or not? So on the ticket, the position of our place will be printed. Yes. So how the seats are there here, how the seats are arranged here, they are arranged in a proper order. Can you find out the order here? They are not scattered here and there. So every seat is there in a proper order so that no confusion is there for the passengers to sit. Yes. So next one more picture also, children. It is also a seating arrangement. So here also we can find out the seating, how the seating is there in a proper way. Yes. So let us see. Here one more picture which is more familiar to you. So everyone will go to movies now. So in theaters, what you will find? The seating arrangement in the theaters. Yes. So how they are? They are in the order. One means if you see here, they are there in a proper line. In a proper line they are. So that means what here in all the pictures till now, whatever we have seen. One is children boarding a school bus. Children standing in an assembly, children doing a march past in the celebrations, Independence Day celebrations, seating arrangement in the aeroplane and seating arrangement in the theater. So in all these pictures, what is the similar point you have understood, similar point you have noted down? So it is the arrangement of the seating, arrangement of seating or arrangement of the children standing. So everything is what, children? It is in a line. It is following a line there. So that means what? If some proper order, the arrangement is there in proper order. Yes. So that means what here? What does it represent? Here this is our totally deep, means it is showing the important concept of our matrices chapter. How it is related? When you will start our main chapter, then we'll discuss. Clear, children? So first of all, that is the matrices chapter. What you are going to see in this entire chapter, let us have an overview of this chapter. Okay, so the chapter name is matrices, children. So what is there in the matrices chapter? So we are going to see the types of matrices. Next, operations on matrices, means different operations we do. We do addition, we do subtraction, we do multiplication. So different addition, different operations we do, children. So we'll come to know later. Okay, transpose we do. So and we'll find inverse. So similar thing, many things are there which we are going to do. And next thing is what? A determinant, the most important topic, determinants. And next one is inverse of a matrix. For any matrix, we are trying to find out the inverse. Okay. Next one is rank of a matrix. Next one is consistent and inconsistent equations. And next thing is solution of simultaneous linear equations. So these are all the things what you are going to see in our chapter, children. Okay. So in today's class, this is an overview of the entire chapter, children, which you are going to see in further classes. Okay. So now here in today's class, what you are going to see, we'll see now. So what you are going to learn in today's session, we are going to see the definition of a matrix. So what does a matrix mean? How do you define a matrix and how a matrix is written, means notation of a matrix and its elements. How to write a matrix and how the elements are written in that. So we are going to see that. Next thing is what? Order of a matrix. So what is the order? So till now we are seeing in all the pictures we have seen order. Yes. So here for a matrix also we have an order. So that's why only I have shown you that pictures, children. So what is the order of a matrix? And next one is what? Square matrix, means types of matrices are there. So among the many types of matrices, one or two we are going to see in today's class. One is a square matrix, and the next one is trace of a matrix. Next one is diagonal matrix. So these are the points which are going to learn in today's session, children. So hope you have understood, you got interest in today's chapter by seeing that pictures and all those. So what is that? Let us start our topic, children. So first of all, be ready with your pen and book, children, and note down the points, important points, whatever I'm giving. Okay. So now let us start our topic, children. So what is this actually? Well, first of all, let us see here an example I'm showing here. Here consider two equations I'm writing. So what is this? One is x plus y is equal to 6, 2x minus y is equal to 5. What is this, children? By seeing these two equations, what comes to your mind? In your 10th class, you have learned about linear equations. Yes or not? So these two are what? They are the linear equations in two variables. What are the two variables here we have? One is x and other one is y. So what we do with these two equations, children? So when you solve these two equations, we are going to get the values for the variables x and y, isn't it? So how do you solve, children? Many methods we have. We have substitution method, we have elimination method, yes, isn't it? So that means what here? In the two different methods, by substitution method or by elimination method, and one more method is there. What is that? Completing the square method. Completing the square method is for quadratic equations, children. And here for linear equations, we have substitution method and elimination method. So in these two, by solving using any one of those methods, we solve this equation. Yes, so we get the values for x and y. Similarly, here suppose if you have one more example I'm giving you. This is a equation, this is a second equation, and this is a third equation. So here, what is the difference you find from the previous example? Here we have, these are also linear equations only. But how many variables do we have here? Here we have three variables are there. One is x, y, and z. So always remember, children, to solve the equations means to find out the solutions for the variables. How many variables you have in an equation? That many equations we need to get them solved. Always remember this point, children. How many variables you are having to solve, or you are going to find out the values? That many equations are required. Is it clear? So two variables are there means two equations we need. Three variables are there means we need three equations. So like that, four variables means four equations. So if you compare to the the previous example, if you compare the previous example with this example, what I am showing here. Okay. So which one is easier, children? Which method means which one solving of which kind of equations is easier? Obviously, everyone say that linear equations with two variables is simple. Yes or not? Here, if you have three variables, this is also somewhat easy only, because only one variable increase of only one variable is there. So it is also simple. Yes, we can solve it. Compared to that, it is little tougher. Like this, suppose if I go on increasing the variables, that means whenever the number of variables is increasing, to solve them, what you have to increase? The number of equations are also increased. So as now, just now I said, how many variables are there? That many equations we need to get them solved. So if I increase the number of variables, then obviously we have to increase the number of equations also. So then definitely what happens, children? It becomes very, very difficult to solve. It is not at all easy. It is very, very difficult to solve. So to have a solution for this kind of problem means where there are many equations with many variables, to have a solution for this, the concept of matrices was developed. Is it clear? So what is the reason behind developing the matrices? So now here, who developed this one, children? He is a mathematician, children. He is a British mathematician. Name is Arthur Cayley. So he is a person who developed the theory of matrices. Clear, children? So he is a person who is behind the development of this matrices, the concept of our theory of matrices. Clear, children? So And very, very interesting topic, children, this is. And then here, what is the use of matrices? Matrices are useful in what? To express the numerical information in compact form. Compact means what, children? Compact means what? Very small. Compact means small. Means the more number of equations with more number of variables we are saying. So it is what? If the data is very huge data, that is. So that huge data, we are trying to put in a compact form within the matrix. The matrices is a plural form. Matrix is a singular word. Okay. So we are trying to put the huge data in the simple form, the compact form within a matrix. Clear? So let us see how to do it. So what is a matrix? Let us have a look. A matrix is a two-dimensional or rectangular arrangement in the form of horizontal lines and vertical lines. So what is it, children? What is a matrix? Matrix is nothing but it is an arrangement. First of all, it is an arrangement. So how it should be? It is a two-dimensional arrangement. Two-dimensional means what, children? What are the two-dimensional figures we have? Square, rectangle, yes or not? So like that, it is a two-dimensional. Means what? We are the horizontal lines and vertical lines. These are the horizontal lines and these are the vertical lines. How they look? Means if you arrange that horizontal lines and vertical lines together, we call it as a matrix. That arrangement is called as a matrix. So how are they? Let us see. Horizontal lines are called as what? Horizontal lines look like this. Yes? You can see these lines, no? Yes. So these are the lines which are called as horizontal lines and they are called as rows. So there is a name for those lines, children. That is rows. And what are vertical lines? Vertical lines are nothing but these are the vertical lines and they are called as what? Columns. Vertical lines are named as columns. Horizontal lines are named as rows. Is it clear, children? So the combination of these two, rows and columns together, if you write as an arrangement, if you write them together, that is called as what? That arrangement is called as a matrix. So how does a matrix look? Now here individually we are seeing the rows and individually we are seeing the columns. Now if you write them together, how does they look? Let us see. Okay, so what is this, children? By seeing this, what do you understand? It is a table. Yes or not? It is a table. So what do you have in this table? We have rows. So what are the rows we have? This is the first row, this is the second row, and this is a third row. And what else you have? If you see like this, if you see like this, they are called as what? Just now I said vertical lines. They are called as what? Columns. So they are called as columns. How many columns we have here? One. This is the first column, and this is the second column, and this is the third column. This is the fourth column, and this is the fifth column. Is it clear? So now here, this is a table. What is it called, children? It is called as a tabular form. It is called as a tabular form. So what we are going to do with this, in this tabular form, we are trying to insert some data. We are trying to insert some data. So that means what? I am trying to put some values over here. Understood, children? So these are the, so in the first row, I have put these values. In the second row, I have put these values. And in the third row, we have put the values. Now here, these becomes the first column values. These are second column. These are third column values. These are fourth column values. These are fifth column values. Understood, children? So what is it called? It is a representation of the data in the tabular form. Is it clear? So it is a representation of data in the tabular form. So now here we are talking about what? We are talking about matrices. Yes. So when there's a data in the tabular form, how do you represent that in matrix? When the data is there in tabular form, how do you represent that in the matrix form? So let us see that. So like this we have to represent. So that means if you observe here, the same data, children, the same values I'm taking here. These are the values which are entered, but here instead of that tabular form, we have showing this in the matrix form. So what is the matrix form? This, if you observe the square brackets, do you observe here, children? So within the square brackets, if you write the data, that is called as a matrix. That is called as a matrix. Now here, what is this one? It is a first row, the elements in the first row. And what is this? Elements in the second row. And what is this? Elements in the third row. And similarly, these are the columns, elements in the first, second, third, fourth, fifth. Clear? So like this we have to represent in the matrix form. So let us see here, children. In this, we have three rows, as I said. Yes. Next one is what? What are the three rows here, children? This arrow mark, what which the arrow mark is pointing towards this line. Yes, this is the first row, and this is the second row, and this is the third row. Similarly, five columns are there as you are seeing it, observing it. First column, second column, third column, fourth column, and fifth column. Is it clear? So like this, we have to represent the data. What you have represented in the tabular form, the same data is now representing in a different way. In matrix form, we are representing it. Clear, children? So now let us see here. Again, I'm taking the same matrix, children. So what now we are saying, the rows, three rows are there and five columns are there, we are saying. So now here, this is a representation of matrix also, we are saying. Now how to represent the rows, how to represent the rows and how to represent the columns. Clear? So let us see that. How many rows we have here? Three rows are there. So what is the first row, children? Can you tell what is the first row? Just now we have seen that the arrow mark is pointing towards what? This line, yes or not? So this is your first row. This is the row, first row is denoted as R1. So which line is showing the first row, children? This entire line means what? All the values, whatever you are seeing here in the first line, that is called as a row one, that is called as a first row. It is denoted by R1. R1 shows that first row, or row one also we can say, or first row also we can say. It is denoted by that. This is a notation, children, how to write the row one, which is R1. Clear? Similarly, what is R2? That is row two, or second row. Which is the second row, children? This whole values, the line, this entire line is called as the second row. Next one is what? Row three, or third row. It is what? This is the line which is showing the third row. These are all the values which are in the third row. Is it clear, children? This is the first row. This is the second row. This is the third row. They are all written within the square brackets, children. Are you observing it? So this is the representation of a matrix. That is a row representation I have shown you. Now similarly, let us see the column representation also. So this is a matrix what we have. How many columns we find here, children? How many columns are there? How many columns you can see? Five columns are there. Yes. Now, which is the first column? This is the C1. Yes. So let us see here. This is the first column. Means all these values are representing the values in the first column. Similarly, column 2. This is the column 2. Similarly, column 3. Yes. Column 4. Next one is what? Last column, which is fifth column, which is 9, 3 and minus 2. So what are the values? Means every value should be considered as the value in the column 1. We cannot leave any one value, children. Any of the values we cannot leave. Entire values should be taken as the values in the first column. And similarly, entire values here should be taken as the values in the row. First row or second row or third row. Whatever you are considering. Is it clear, children, about the rows and columns? So now here, let us see the actual definition of the matrix. So as you have seen that it is nothing but a rectangular arrangement, I said. Yes. So what is a rectangular arrangement of elements? Here I am using a word ordered. Ordered rectangular array. Array is nothing but arrangement only, children. So an ordered rectangular array of elements is called a matrix. That means what? Ordered. Why are you saying ordered? It must follow a proper order. Means one row after the other. One row after the other. Or one column after the other. So every value should be properly arranged. Understood, children? Every value should be properly arranged. So then only it is called as ordered. So the ordered rectangular array of elements is called a matrix. Clear, children? So now here, one second, children. Here A is there, children, rectangular. Okay. So now here an ordered rectangular array of elements is called what? It is a matrix. Clear, children? Now What is how does the matrix look like? How they means? How do you write the elements in the matrix? The matrix consists of individual elements. As you have seen, the values whatever you have entered. So the individual elements, they are called as what? Entries also we can call them, children. So they are called as elements or entries. So they are written enclosed in the brackets. Which brackets we can use? Either square brackets or open brackets. These are the open brackets, children. So either square brackets we can use or open brackets also we can use. Clear? So in general, so now here whenever you are writing the matrix, you should give a name for it. Yes? So the matrices are denoted by capital letters, that is A, B, C, so on. So any alphabet we can give as a name, means to identify the matrix, which matrix we are considering. So to identify the matrix, you should give a name. Yes? How we have names. Yes? So why the names are given to us, children? To identify us. Yes or not? Similarly, matrices also should be identified. So by the names which are given to them. So they are given by A, B, C and so on. Okay. Now the entries in the matrix. So what kind of entries we can have in a matrix? Means just now I have entered the values. Means I have entered the numbers. So but any other thing can be entered in the matrix. Yes, we can enter other things also. They can be symbols, we can enter numbers, we can enter alphabets, we can enter expressions. So anything we can enter, we can enter in the matrix, we can write in the matrix as the elements of the matrix. Is it clear? So let us see few examples of matrix. So now here, there is a matrix A. Here I'm showing few elements are written here, children, few values. Here I'm, what are the elements here? 1, 2 are in the first row, 3, 0 are in the second row, minus 4, 2 are in the third row. See, children, whenever you are telling about the matrix, means the arrangement of the matrix, we can say either row wise we can say or column wise we can say. Is it clear? Because in, if you say column wise, I say that 1, 3, minus 4 are in the first column, 2, 0, 2 are in the second column. If you say row wise, 1, 2 are in the first row, 3, 0 are in the second row, minus 4, 2 are in the third row. So that means every element is covered here. Every element, about every element we are saying, but either row wise we can say or along column wise also we can say. Clear? So this is a matrix A which has numbers in it. Now see here, how many rows it has? 3 rows and 2 columns are there. Now I'm saying here, I'm showing you again another matrix which is B. What is here? A, B, C, minus D are in the first row, minus E, F, G, H are in the second row. That means here I have used alphabets. Lowercase alphabets or uppercase, anything we can use, children, only to show that numbers, alphabets, anything we can write in the matrix. Now, what is the number of rows and number of columns here? 2 rows and 4 columns are there. And one more matrix I am showing you here, that is C, X plus 1, X square plus 2, cos X, sin X. So these are all what, children? These are the trigonometric expressions. These are the algebraic expressions. Means we can have any kind of expressions in the matrix as the elements. Clear? So how many rows it has, children? First row, second row. How many columns it has? First column, second column. That means C has 2 rows and 2 columns. Is it clear? So that means a matrix is written within the square brackets or open brackets. The elements can be either numbers or alphabets or any expressions, any kind of expressions we can have. And alpha matrices are named, denoted by what? Capital letters A, B, C and so on. Clear, children? Now, let us move on to the order of a matrix. So we have seen many pictures in the beginning of our session. So it is about what? Order of a matrix. We have seen the order where everyone is standing in a proper order. The seating arrangement was there in a proper order. Yes. So now what is how it is related to our matrix? So let us see now. What is the order of a matrix? Now, a matrix having m rows and n columns is said to be of order m by n. So this should be read as, children, m by. This into symbol is there now. This should be read as by. Okay. M by n. So here a matrix is having m rows. So usually, children, the number of rows is denoted by M and the number of columns is denoted by N. Clear? So M number of rows and N number of columns is what, if the matrix is having these many rows and columns, we say it as its order is M by N. Clear? So that means what? Order. Order, there is other name for order, children. We can say it as size of the matrix also. We can say it as dimension of the matrix also. All the meaning means all these three words mean same. But usually we use order only. But the meaning is same. If you anywhere, if you find the word size of a matrix or dimension of a matrix, that is also same as order only. Okay. So order or size or dimension of a matrix is given by what? What does m by n we are saying? What does m represents, children? It is a number of rows. And what does n represents? Number of columns. So in general, what we say? The order is given by number of rows by number of columns. Number of rows by number of columns. Whatever may be the number of rows we have, that value is written here and number of columns will be written here. Is it understood, children? Clear? Yes. So the next one is what? In the previous example, we have seen three examples we have seen. One is the matrix A, matrix B and matrix C. So in that examples, A has how many rows? Three rows and two columns were there. So then what is the order of A then? So according to this rule, number of rows by number of columns. So what is the order of A, children? Always number of rows should be written here. Number of columns should be written here. Yes. So what will be the order? Can anyone tell? What is the order? Yes. I hope you are trying, children. A is of order 3 by 2. A is of order 3 by 2. Clear? Now next one is what? One more example. Because three rows are there and two columns are there. Next one more example was B. B has two rows and four columns. Yes, isn't it? So that means what? Again, the what is the order of the matrix B? B is of order 2 by 4 because rows number should be written first and columns numbers should be written next. So it is nothing but 2 by 4. Next is what? One more matrix is there, C. C is of order. C has two rows and two columns. Yes. So what is order here? C is of order 2 by 2. Yes. Understood, children? So like this, you have to write the order of a matrix. Means you have to see how many rows are present in the matrix and how many columns are present in the matrix. So by knowing that, we can write the order of any given matrix. Because the order is very, very important, children. Order plays an important role in the matrix. Clear? So try to understand order very much clearly. Next one. See here, in general. So we are saying about two rows, three rows, or three columns, four columns. So in general, a matrix is having how many rows? M number of rows and N number of columns, we find. Yes? So then how does a matrix look? If it has M rows and N columns, how does a matrix look? Let us see. So now this is a matrix, children. I'm naming it as A. So A11, A12, so on, A1J, so on, A1N. So what is this, children? What is the first line of the matrix called? What is the first horizontal line of the matrix called? It is what? It is a row. Yes, row one, first row. We call it as first row. So, and what is the first line of the matrix called? Vertical line, first vertical line of the matrix called? It is a column one. Yes, it's a first column. So now here I'm writing the elements as A11. This is a general matrix, children. So in this place, you can have any elements. Okay. So this I'm writing here A11. Yes, are you able to see? What is this A11, children? It is a element in the place. Element in the place, first row, first column. This element, where does this element located, children? It is there in the first row and in the first column. Yes. So this is what it is as how everyone has address. Yes, we have we stay at one particular place. So means if anyone asks you where do you stay, what do you tell? We tell the address where we stay. Yes or not? We tell the address. So that address, how do you tell? Means I stay in so and so particular colony or so and so particular lane. Yes, fourth house or fifth house we say. So that anyone can come to your house easily. They can locate your house easily. Similarly, in the matrix also, when you are having so many elements in the matrix, to identify where a particular element is there. So for that reason, we have to give the address for that particular element. Understood, children? You have to give the address for that particular element. So how the address is given? It is the, now what is address of this element, children? It is located in the first row and first column. So that's why we are writing it as A11. Means A is an element which is located in first row, first column. And what is this? A is located in first row and second column. It is in the second column. So A12. So on, if you go on writing, because this whole thing is a first row, every element, this one doesn't change. A12, A13, A14, A15, so on. Suppose in the middle somewhere you have this jth column. This is the first column, this is second column, third column, fourth column, so on. This is a jth column, J. Okay, the column number is J. So how do we write this? A1J. Okay, so on. And how many total number of columns are there? N columns. This means the last column should be the nth one. Yes or not? See, if you have 5 columns, the last column will be the 5th column, no? So similarly, if you have n number of columns, the last column will be the nth column. So that's why here, what is the address of this element here? A1N. Means it is located in the first row and nth column. Is it clear, children? This is about the first row. Second row also similar. What is the amount of this? What is the address of this? It is a second row and first column. So that's why here we are writing it as A21. It is a second row, second column. A22. So on. Second row, jth column. That is A2J. So on. A2N means second row and in the nth column. Understood, children? So we are trying to tell the addresses of the each element. Okay. Similarly, as you move on like this, row wise, somewhere I have entered the ith row. So what is the row here? What is the address of this element? AI1. It is in the ith row and first column. So it is what? AI1 we say. Okay. And what is this? This entire row is what? Ith row only. Yes. So AI2. So on. And this column, what we say? It is what we have said it. It has jth column, no? So this element will be Aij. This element will be Aij. Means the element is in the ith row and jth column. Ith row and jth column. So on. Ain means A, this element is there in the ith row and nth column. Similarly, you move on row wise again. So we reach the last row. So what is the last row? How many rows are there? M number of rows are there. So mth row will be the last row. That is mth row and first column. So this element is in the mth row and first column. That is am1, am2, so on. What is this? Amj. Means it is in the mth row and jth column. Amj and so on. What is the last element of the matrix? It is in the mth row. That is the last row and last column. So that's why what is the address of this? AMN means A is this element is in the mth row and nth column. Understood, children? Is it clear about the addresses of the elements? I mean, how the location of the element is given? Yes? I hope you have understood it. So once again, listen, children, always the element should be represented by its location. I mean, identified by its location or by its address. So how do you identify? The element is in which row and which column. The element is in which row and which column the element is present. That will give you the address of the element of the matrix. Okay. So in general, so this is about all the elements, every element we are saying. So in general, so these are all the number of rows, children. As I said, these are all the number of rows. 1, 2, so on. This is the ith row and this is the mth row. And these are all the columns. 1, 2, so on. This is a jth column and this is the nth column. Clear, children? Now, to be more clear, in compact form, how do you write a matrix? Matrix is denoted by A is equal to Aij. This is the order, children. M by N. So, a matrix is of order. Means compact form means I told you already. Small form. Yes? So, in the smaller form, how do you write the matrix? As Aij means this is an element, because in the matrix, what do you have? We have the elements. So any number of elements you may have in the matrix, children. So the general element is represented by Aij. The general element is represented by Aij. So this A can have any value. This I can have any value. J can have any value. Understood, children? But that any value is having certain condition. What is that certain condition? because its order is m by n. What is m by n? It has this matrix A has m rows and n columns, m number of rows and n number of columns. So the I value should start from 1, because first row, we start always I is representing row, no? So always we start from the first row until where we can have, the till the maximum number of rows, how many it has. So what are the maximum number of rows it has? M. So it cannot cross m value, no? So that means what here, children? The I value is there between I less than or equal, 1 less than or equal to I less than or equal to M. Means, suppose if I value is 2, that means it is a row, second row. If I value is 3, that means it is third row, or it has 3 rows. So like that, you can have any number of rows. Suppose if you have some 5 rows in our matrix. So suppose I want to tell I value is 3. That means we are representing what there? Third row. We are representing third row. Means the third row is lying between the first row and fifth row. M value I'm taking as I 5, no? So the third row which you are representing is lying between first row and the fifth row. So like that, always the first row and the last row. Last row is what? How many rows? The maximum number of rows present in the matrix will be there as the M value. Okay, this is a condition for the I. Similarly, for J also, 1 less than or equal to J less than or equal to N. Means it can have the column number which you are representing will always lies between 1, and that is the first column, and the last column. N is representing the last column. Suppose if you may get a doubt. Suppose if J value is 1 or I value is 1, then what happens? Yes, that's why here we are showing equal to symbol also. If I value is 1, then that itself means instead of less than, here we take equal to sign. Understood? So that 1 is less than M. Similarly, if you take the value as I is 5, means as I said, 5 rows are there. If I value is 5, then what happens? Then it will take the equal to sign here. It is equal to the maximum number of rows, fifth one. Clear? So like that, it can be 1 less than or equal to I less than or equal to M, 1 less than or equal to J less than or equal to N. Understood, children? And always, in general, the element is represented by Aij. So this I will tell the row number and J will tell the column number in which the element is present, as you have seen in the previous slide. Okay, so here let us see, in any matrix, Aij denotes what? Just now I said you, children, position of an element. Position or nothing but address also we can say, means where does the element is located. So what does it tells us? It tells us the row and the column in which the element is present in the matrix. Means in which row it is present and in which column it is present. So here the two element, the two things here we are able to see, that is I and J. What does this I and J represent in this Aij? In Aij, I is called as what? Row index. And J is called as column index. Means what? Row index means it tells us the row number in which the element is present. Column index means it tells us the column number in which the element is present. Understood, children? So this is about the representation of a matrix, and how does a matrix how the elements are there in the matrix, how many rows and columns we can have in a matrix, and what is the M is representing the rows and N represents the columns, and element is represented by Aij, where I represents the row number, a row index we can say, J represents the column number or column index. Is it clear, children? Now let us see here. Let us see an example here. How do you find the location of an element? Suppose this is a matrix here. How many rows are there, children, here? First row, second row, third row. Yes? How many columns are there? First column, second column, third column. So here I am trying to find out what is the element present in A, 2, 3. What is the element present in A, 2, 3? My question is this one. Yes? That means what, children? We have to find out the element which is present in second row and third column. Because this is what? It is the Aij. It is representing what? Aij. Where I place is taken by 2, J place is taken by 3. Means I represents the row number and J represents the column number. So how do you find out? Let us see. So this is our matrix. What we need, children? A, 2, 3 value we need. Okay. So where is our second row? This is the first row and this is our second row, isn't it? So first we have to see the second row. Where is the second row? So this is your second row. Clear? Now next what you have to see? We have to see for the third column. See for the third column. Where is the third column, children? Yes, you are right. It is the third column. First column, second column, and third column. Now next one is what? The element which is there in second row and third column. Which element is there, children? Which element is there? Means where the place which is intersecting by both the lines. What is it? Yes, it is nothing but 4. Yes, this element is there in the second row and third column. So like this we have to see. Means whatever the element is asked to you, we can locate the element or we can find out the address of the element. So let us see one more example, children. Suppose the same matrix I'm taking here. Suppose I want to find out the element in the position A32. A32 is what? It is in the third. I'm reversing the numbers here. In earlier we found A23 position. Now we are finding A32 position. So A32 is what? It is a third row and it is a second column. Third row and the second column. So which is our third row? This is our third row. First row, second row, and this is our third row. And what is our second column? This is the first column and this is our second column. Yes. Now we don't want our third column because our question is to find out the element in third row and second column only. So now which element is there in third row and second column? You are able to see that it is nothing but 0. Yes. Yes. It is what? 0 is the element in that particular place. Clear, children? Understood, everyone? I hope you understood how to identify the element in any location asked. Okay, now let us see here. One more interesting, important topic. Types of matrices. So till now we have seen what is a matrix and what kind of, how many rows and columns and what is the order of a matrix, what is the element of a matrix, how to identify an element in a matrix, how to find out the location of an element in the matrix. All these things you have learned. Yes. Now let us see how many, what are the types of different types of matrices we have. So many are there, children. So few we are seeing today. Okay. So first one is what? Square matrix. First matrix is what? Square matrix. So what is the meaning of square, children? The name itself tells us what is the meaning of square. Because the definition of matrix itself tells us that matrix is an arrangement, rectangular arrangement we are seeing. Means which has rectangular arrangement has what? What does it has? It has a the horizontal line dimension is there and vertical dimension is also there. Horizontal dimension is there and vertical dimension is also there. Is it clear? Now let us see here for the square also, you have a horizontal dimension and vertical dimension. Yes. So let us see what is it. When you call it as a square, children, what is the definition of a square actually? We know that where the length and breadth are equal. There are all the four sides are equal. That only we say as a square. Yes. Similarly, here also the horizontal dimensions or dimension is called as what in our matrices? In the language of matrices, we call it as rows. Yes. So in the vertical dimension is called as what? It is called as columns. Yes. Now here, that is the definition we give for matrix. What is that? A matrix in which the number of rows is equal to the number of columns is called a square matrix. So where the number of rows and number of columns are equal, that matrix is called as a square matrix. Is it clear, children? Now let us see here, mathematically, how do you write this? This is a theoretical statement. So mathematically, how do you write that? If a matrix A is equal to Aij, this already I told children, representing matrix in the compact form. Okay, this is an element, any element which is written in the matrix whose order is m by n. If it is a square matrix, then m will be equal to n. So when you call this as a square matrix, if m is equal to n, what is m? M is the number of rows. What is n? It is a number of columns. Is it clear? So this is a square matrix. When you say this as a square matrix, we say it as m, when m is equal to n, then only it is called as a square matrix. Means number of rows must be equal to number of columns. Clear, children? So in case, because when both, see here in the order, when you are saying the order, m by n we are saying, because m is a different, m can be different number and n can be different number, isn't it, children? But when it comes for the square matrix where m and n both are same, instead of writing two same values here, or m by m or n by n, clear? Simply we can say A is a square matrix of order m. Understood, children? Means A, suppose if it has two rows and two columns, then we can say that it is an order 2 instead of saying 2 by 2. Okay, so that example we see here, children. Suppose here this is there. Here only one element we find out. Okay, so it is also a square matrix of order 1 because it has only one row and one column. This itself is the row and this itself is the column. Yes. So that's why here we say that instead of writing 1 by 1, we write it as square matrix of order 1. Clear? Similarly, one more example we see here. This is another example. How many rows we have here? First row and second. How many columns we have? First column, second column. So that means here number of rows is same as number of columns. So it is written as, what is the order of this? 2 by 2. So instead of writing 2 by 2, we can simply write it as order 2. Only in case of square matrix only it is there, children. If rows and columns number is different, then we cannot write like this. You have to write in the form of m by n only. Okay. So, and another matrix I'm taking here. First row, second row, third row. So total 3 rows are there. First column, second column, third column. So total 3 columns are there. So here the number of rows and columns is same. We write it as square matrix of order 3. Understood, children? So let us see one more important concept of this square matrix, which is principal diagonal. It is a principal diagonal. So what is the meaning of principal, children? We have our principals in our colleges, yes or not? Yes. What is what do you mean by principal? They are the head of the institution and they are the key person in our college, yes or not? Similarly, whenever you have a square matrix, we have two diagonals. For any square, we have two diagonals or not? As you all are aware of square, how many diagonals we find? Two diagonals are there. So in that two diagonals, one diagonal is called as principal diagonal, which is the most important diagonal. Okay, as our in our college, among all the staff, how the principal is a key person in our college, here in the two diagonals, the principal diagonal is a key diagonal or very important diagonal. Clear, children? So which diagonal is called as the principal diagonal? Let us see. The diagonal with elements A11, A22, A33, so on, ANN. So what is it, children? What do you observe here? A11 means first row, first column. What is this? Second row, second column. What is this? Third row, third column, so on. Nth row, nth column. Okay. Of a square matrix is called principal diagonal of the square matrix. Means, if you means here, these are all representing what? They are all the elements in the matrix. So among all the elements, because here I'm saying it as a square matrix, so it is must that rows and columns must be in equal number. Is it clear? So when the rows and columns are in equal number, or when it is a square matrix, so the elements which are present in these locations or in these positions, A11, A22, A33, so on, ANN, in all these positions, we say it as the principal diagonal. Okay, so let us see how it is. If I is equal to J, then Aij is the element of the diagonal. Okay, that means what? A11. Yeah, what is a means in general, how do you represent an element Aij, as we have discussed earlier? Yes, so I value is 1, J value is 1. Means here I is equal to J or not? Yes, here also I is 2, J is 2. Means I is equal to J. Here also same, I is equal to J. Here also I is equal to J. Means among all the elements, wherever the I value is same as the J value, those elements, if you see together, that is the diagonal called, that diagonal is called as a principal diagonal. Is it clear, children? Now let us see here one more important example we are going to see for the principal diagonal. So here, what is the square matrix? Here we have first row, second row, third row, first column, second column, third column. So total 3 rows are there, 3 columns are there. So is it a square matrix or not? Yes, it is a square matrix of order 3. Okay, now we are going to see the principal diagonal. What is the principal diagonal? What I have said, first row, first column. The element must be in the first row, first column. So which element is there? This element is there. One. Yes. And what is element in the second row, second column? Second row and second column. So this element is there. Observe the number which I am circling here. Next one is what? Third row, third column. Which element is there? Six. Yes. Now which three elements are there in the place where I is equal to j? 1, 5, 6, isn't it? So that means what here, children? These are the three elements which are in the principal diagonal. So that is what in the first position, that is A11, we have 1, and in position A22, we have 5, and in position A33, we have 6. So this is called as a principal diagonal. If you observe here, children, here also one more diagonal we have, because it is a square, we have one more diagonal. Which are the elements? 3, 5, minus 2. This is also a diagonal, yes or not? But what is the location here? What is the address of this 3? It is in the first row, third column. Means what is the position here? A13. So their I value is 1 and J value is 3. Are they equal? No. But what is our condition for the principal diagonal? I value must be same as J. That is row number must be same as column number. So that means these are the three elements. That's why this diagonal is a, it is just a diagonal. It is not the principal diagonal. Okay. So always we talk about the principal diagonal only. Okay. So means in your textbooks also, children, we find the diagonal, the word diagonal. So here the diagonal means principal diagonal only. So don't consider this one. Okay. You have to consider only this diagonal, which is our principal diagonal. So where the I value is same as J, these elements, the elements which are present in this diagonal is called as what? The principal diagonal. Clear, children? So next one, based on the principal diagonal concept, we have one important concept, that is trace of a matrix. This concept is important, children, for your 2 marks question. It is many times you are asked to find the trace of a matrix. So this is very, very important for 2 marks. Okay, the trace of a matrix. Now, what is a trace of a matrix? The sum of the elements of the diagonal of a square matrix A is called the trace of A. It is denoted by TR of A. So what is the trace of a matrix? The sum of the elements of the diagonal. The diagonal means what? Just now I said, diagonal means principal diagonal only. Okay. So the sum of the elements of the diagonal of a square matrix A. So we know for any square matrix, how to find out the diagonal. And just now we have discussed. Okay. So when you know the diagonal, whatever the elements are there in the diagonal, if you find the sum of those elements, that is nothing but the trace of the matrix. Clear? So let us see an example here. This is a matrix A. 1, 3, 3, 1, 5, 4, minus 2, 0, 6. So as I said, children, you can read the elements row wise or column wise. So now, what is the diagonal here? What is the principal diagonal, or simply diagonal we can say? What is the diagonal, children? Yes. So this is our diagonal. And what are the elements we have in the diagonal? 1, 5, 6. Yes. Let us try to find out the trace of this matrix. Trace of this matrix is what? One, sum of all the elements I said, no? 1 plus 5 plus 6. That's why here we are doing 1 plus 5 plus 6 is how much? 12. Clear? So the trace of this matrix is how much, children? 12 is the trace of the matrix. So this question is important for, as I said, for 2 marks. Clear, children? So this is a concept of trace of a matrix. Next concept is, next another kind of, one more example we are seeing here. That is B is equal to sine square x, 0, 0 and cos square x. So these are the 4 elements we have. So how many rows and how many columns we have? This is the first row and this is the second row. First column, second column. So it is 2 rows and 2 columns it has. So what is order of this? It is an order of 2. Okay. Now, what is the trace of this matrix? Let us find. Before finding the trace, what you should find out, what you should know to get the trace of matrix, what you need to find, you need to know the diagonal. Okay. Which is the diagonal? So let us find out the first, let us find out the diagonal. Which is the diagonal, children? It is the diagonal of this matrix, that is sine square x and cos square x is there. So now trace of B, what is trace? We have to add these 2 elements. If you add these 2 elements, what we get? Sine square x plus cos square x. As we see this, what comes to your mind? 10th class, what you have learned? sin square x plus cos square x is what, children? In trigonometry chapter, you learnt, no? Trigonometric identity. What is it? This value is equal to 1. Yes? So that means in the matrices, we can have the elements where the trigonometric expressions can also be there. Okay? So, like this, you have to find out the trace of the matrix B. Is it clear, children? I hope everyone is enjoying the class, because the matrices is a very, very interesting chapter, children. As you as you go on doing the chapter, further classes also, it will be very, very interesting and easy to score in the exam, and very much useful, children, because many applications are there for the matrices, children. Means as you know that as a first one important use I told you about the matrix is, what is that? To solve the equations, means when more number of equations, more number of variables are there. Yes, for that reason matrices are developed. So later on, the matrices were found very much useful in different fields. Means in physics, they can use in video games, as nowadays children are very much playing video games, no? So those video games also, for use of computer animations, computer graphics, so in everything they are using the concept of, behind those, the logic, whatever they use, behind them, the logic is, the concept used is matrices. Understood, children? In engineering backgrounds, in physics backgrounds, or scientific technology, whatever you are using nowadays, in everything we have the concept of matrices is used. So many applications are there, children, to find the earthquakes, or you find earthquakes also, the concept of matrices is used. See, we may not be using that, but by learning the matrices in detail in the higher classes. Higher classes, when you reach the higher classes, the matrices, if you go thoroughly with the concept of matrices, if you are going into that field, the usage of matrices is there. Understood? So now that's why matrices is very, very important, children. Now here, for this trace of B we found, children, we are little deviated from the concept. It is not actually deviating, because we need to know the applications of matrices, where it is used. Okay? So I hope you have understood it. Now next one is one more type of matrix we are going to see. That is a diagonal matrix. Here it is a diagonal matrix. So what is a diagonal matrix? Let us see the definition first. If each non-diagonal element of a square matrix is equal to 0, then the matrix is called a diagonal matrix. So what is the definition, children? If each non-diagonal element of a square matrix is equal to 0, then the matrix is called a diagonal matrix. Means what? We know that a square matrix has a diagonal, principal diagonal. Yes? So other than principal diagonal, we find many other elements are not. So they are all what? They are all the elements of the non-diagonal. Non-diagonal means the elements which are not in the diagonal. Okay? So if they are all zeros except the elements in the diagonal. So then such kind of matrix is called diagonal matrix. So let us see the example here. A is equal to 1, 0, 0, 0, 5, 0, 0, 0, 6. So this is an example. So it is a square matrix because it has three rows, first row, second row, third row, first column, second column, third column. So it is three rows and three columns are there. Clear? Now, what is the diagonal here, principal diagonal? This is the principal diagonal already we know. We are very much thorough with this. So now other than the elements in the principal diagonal, the remaining elements, total how many elements are there in a 3x3 matrix or in a matrix of order 3? Total 9 elements will be there. Among these 9 elements, 3 elements comes to the principal diagonal. So the remaining how many elements are there? 6 elements are left. The rest of all the 6 elements must be zeros. Understood, children? Rest of all elements should be zeros. Then this kind of matrix is called a diagonal matrix. It is called as a diagonal matrix. Okay. So now here one more example is, it is a 2x2 matrix, children. So here this is a principal diagonal. Okay. And the remaining 2 elements, because it's a 2x2 matrix, we have 4 elements only. So two are in the principal diagonal. So the remaining 2 elements are zeros. Okay. Now let us see here, children, what have we learnt in today's session. I hope you have enjoyed the class, children. Let us see once again, revise what you have seen in the today's session. First one is definition of matrix we have seen. What is that? It is a rectangular arrangement or an ordered arrangement in the form of rows and columns. Okay, there is a matrix. And next thing is what? Notation. How do you write a matrix? How do you represent a matrix? You represent a matrix in the square brackets or open brackets. The elements are written within the square brackets or open brackets. Okay, like that we represent the matrix. Next one is what? And the matrix are denoted by capital letters A, B, C and so on. Order of a matrix. What is order? Order is nothing but it has the how many rows and how many columns. So that is given by the number of rows by number of columns. Order is nothing but the number of rows by number of columns present in the matrix. Clear, children? So what are the other names for order? Size we can say, or we can say dimension also. Okay. Now next one is what? Types of the matrix. That is square matrix, where the number of rows is equal to number of columns. That matrix is called as a square matrix. Clear? Next one is trace of a matrix. Trace of a matrix is what? It is nothing but the sum of all the elements present in the diagonal of the matrix. Clear? So you know how to find out the diagonal. So if we add up all the elements of the diagonal, that will give you the trace of the matrix. Next one is what? Diagonal matrix. What is a diagonal matrix? The rest, other than the diagonal elements, remaining all elements present in the square matrix are zeros. Okay, then it is called as a diagonal matrix. Clear, children? So this is about the introduction class of matrices, children. So based on this concept, whatever I have taught you, I'm trying to give you a few questions, children. So try to answer them. Very simple questions, children. First question. What is our first question? Find the order of the matrix. This one. So you have to, what is order? You are asked to find the order of the matrix. Means how many rows and how many columns it has. And how to write the order also. Okay. Means first which should come. Means rows number should come first or columns number should come first. You have to write in a proper order. Okay. And second one is find the order of the matrix 3, 1, 0, minus 3, 2. So it has how many rows it has count. Okay. And how many columns it has count. So then write the order in the proper way. Next question is find the A31 element in the matrix. So this is what I'm asking you to find out the position. Means in this position, what is the element? Which element is there in this position? So you're asked to find that. Okay. Next one is what? Find A14 element in the matrix. So in this matrix, find out the element present in this position. Okay, children. So you have learned already how to find out. And fifth one is what? Find the trace of the matrix. Find the trace of the matrix. Secant square x, 0, 0, minus tan square x. Clear, children? So these are the five questions I'm giving you for practice, children. Try to solve the sums because these are the basics which you need to know. To move into the further topics in our matrices chapter. Okay, so be thorough with the top basics, children, because the basics are always the stones for your to know the remaining chapter thoroughly. They become the base. Okay, so base should be there always. Strong base should be there, children. So try to learn it. See the video once again. If you still have any doubt, see the video more and more number of times. Okay, and understand it clearly, children. I hope you enjoyed the class, and thank you for giving me this opportunity, madam. And good day, children. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Purnima, madam, for a wonderful introduction of matrices. Children, I request you to go through the textbook and read each and every line and revise whatever madam has told you today. There are more questions in the textbook. You please solve along with the questions madam has given you. Please solve the other questions also. Madam, thank you for a wonderful session.
Thank you, ma'am.
Just the right beginning for matrices. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am.